A House lawmaker wants actors to undergo mandatory drug tests before they can take on any acting project. That proposal from Surigao del Norte 2nd District Representative Robert Barbers came following the arrest of actor Dominic Rocco and four companions in a buy-bust operation. Barbers, who chairs the House Committee on Dangerous Drugs, adds he has also encouraged his fellow lawmakers to set an example and take drug tests voluntarily.
The past several years, ay meron pong mga iniidolo ng bayan na mga artista na talagang nasangkot sa illegal na droga. At sa aking palagay, ito ay makaka-impluensya sa ating mga kabataan. Yan naman po ay hindi unconstitutional. Meron pong ruling ang Supreme Court dyan.
Meanwhile, Police Chief Rodolfo Azurin Jr. welcomes the lawmaker's proposal to make drug tests for artists mandatory. He says celebrities should serve as a good example to the public.
For Senator Robin Padilla, drug tests should not be mandatory. Robin, who was an actor, clarifies he supports efforts to protect the public, including artists, from dangers of using illegal drugs, but he believes it should not be a requirement as it may be a violation of human rights. Each Filipino now has a debt burden of about 118,000 pesos as the national government's outstanding debt hits 13 trillion. Senators learned this during a budget hearing with the finance department. Now let's get more details from our correspondent Jackie Pascual, who joins us now on the line. Jackie.
Hi, Ron. A newborn child in the Philippines already has a debt of about 118,000 pesos each. At the hearing of the Senate Committee on Finance on the budget of the Department of Finance, the Bureau of Treasury said 110 million Filipinos now has a debt burden of 118,000 pesos each. National Treasurer Rosalia de Leon revealed the debt of the Philippines is now about 13 trillion pesos as of August 2022. This is double than the debt 6 years ago, largely due to the COVID-19 related expenses. De Leon added that for 2023 or for next year, the Philippines would have to pay 1.5 trillion pesos just for debt. This includes the 1 trillion pesos in principal and interest of about 580 billion pesos. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel said with a huge amount, the country should generate more revenues. The Department of Finance targets to generate 3.6 trillion pesos for 2023, a big chunk from the Bureau of Internal Revenue and the Bureau of Customs. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno presented to the committee the agency's proposed budget of 30.6 billion pesos, including those for attached agencies. Jokno also reiterated calls for taxes on online sales for additional revenues. The BIR added it is not targeting small businesses only, but all businesses, including the medium and large companies. And that's the latest. Ron, back to you.
Jackie Pascual with that story. Thanks, Jackie. Philippine Senator Pia Cayetano seeks clarity over the proposed 150 million peso confidential fund under the Education Department's budget for 2023. Cayetano notes this is her first time to hear that the agency is seeking such funds. She says she wants the Education Department to explain how the budget will be utilized. Vice President and Education Secretary Sara Duterte has said the funds will be used to address issues such as sexual grooming, as well as insurgency recruitment and drug involvement of students.
Kung sasabihin naman yung purpose, maganda naman yung purpose, mm-hmm. no? Na yung to protect the learners. I understand. I'm just trying to get a better grasp on whether they handle these actual protective steps such that they have to handle this kind of funding. And does it have to be that much?